Hi everybody, my name is Dennis Woodruff and I'm a filmmaker, and I decided when I was a kid I used to skateboard in Huntington Beach off the pier, not off the pier, on the pier. And me and my partner, business partner Keith Kurlander, we were talking about the possibilities. We've made a surfing movie and we wanted to bring you a really cool movie. We had an idea to make a movie about skateboarding. And the name of our movie is VORTEX, and I know you're going to really like it. It's a little different than some of the skateboarding movies you've seen, but ours is kind of different, and we have our own style, and I think you'll notice that. What we want to bring to your attention and for your enjoyment is how wonderful this sport really is. And the people that get involved in skateboarding, it's a universal truth that they're all really cool, awesome people, and they love the sport. And the VORTEX is what they get into when they get into the sport, and they just love it and they just want to do it again and again. And what's great about it, it gets you in shape, it gets your mind in shape, and it's good exercise, and it's a good, clean, healthy sport for all ages. However, there's a few bad things that you'll find out about, like little injuries you can get, but there's pads you can wear. And this is one of the local skate spots in Hollywood. It's Bronson Canyon. Right behind me is the Dragon. And a lot of the locals skate here, and they have a lot of fun, and they hang out here. And they're really cool people, and they never hurt anyone, and they're just like really positive, and they just love to skate. So let's go on this adventure and see all about skateboarding. I'm going to try to show you a balance between the beginners and the pros and the middle and all aspects of skateboarding. So join me on this great adventure, and I call the movie VORTEX.
Bobby Brown, welcome you to Venice Beach, the skateboard capital of the world. I hope your dreams come true, because mine has. I just bought a vineyard.
Right on. The world's greatest wino.
All right.
Woo!
Yeah, man.
Is that your
Alexis?
I'm
Lindsay.
I'm Alexis, my girl Lindsay.
I'm Lindsay.
She's sizzling
and
hats.
We're in Venice Beach.
And it's our second home. I love to be here. You'll find me here every day, mostly. Especially Sundays on drum circles. Drum circles are the best.
You know what I say? You're hot like a chili pepper. Good boy, Tuff. Welcome everybody to the world famous Venice Skate Park, right on the ocean, dude. You're in for a surprise. We're gonna entertain you with all the latest skateboarding you ever imagined. Yeah, folks, who's going to be the next superstar in the world of skateboarding? Awesome, man. They're letting it rip out here in Venice. We're trying to get the best of the best, and even the worst. Hope you're enjoying yourself. I am. Whoa. Whoa. Dude, it's crazy. Crazy good.
Hey, man.
My dog loves skateboarding. He loves it.
It's like the rest of us.
Hey, dude. Excuse me. What's your name? My brother's a big skateboarding fan, and I'm making. Jason. Yeah. Man, you rock, man. Thanks, man. You're like hot, man. You're smoking.
Thanks, man.
Awesome. Awesome, dude. Awesome. Tearing it up. Ooh, I bet that hurt. Just goes right back at it like it never happened. I think these are the real tough guys of sports right here. What's your name?
Janine.
And how long have you been skateboarding? Because you're really tearing it up out here.
Oh, thank you. A couple months, really.
Really?
No. After the skate park opened.
Uh-huh. How long have you been skateboarding?
A few months since after.
That's it? And
yeah.
You've learned that fast?
Yeah.
Unbelievable. I mean, I'd like to see more girls out here enjoying the sport.
Me too, honestly.
You know what
me
I'm
too.
Saying? I think it's cool to have girls get involved in the sport as well as guys.
Yeah, there's not enough girls who can actually like shred and really, really actually rip shit up. It's like one sports that I'm really just disappointed with the girls. Like when it comes to like pro level, like surfing girls fucking rip it up. There's some sick ass girl surfers. But fucking skateboarding, they all suck. Well, you know, they get to a point and then it's kind of like plateaus. They need someone to really step it up and.
Maybe you'll get sponsored.
Hey, I don't really skate hard anymore. I kind of cruise it. I have too many injuries, so. You know.
How many parts of your body have you?
26 bones.
Oh my God.
Eight of them were fingers, though. So.
You're a rebel.
I'm accident.
She's a rebel, huh?
I'm always just getting over some kind of accident.
Yeah,
I got some.
Day.
Yeah. Wow. Look at that. Gnarly.
Skateboard drunk with. Glass bottles.
Oh my God.
Could
you guys do a little skateboarding for me, real quick?
Sure.
See, let's see what you do.
We don't want to hook up. I broke my ball.
We had a long night last night.
I did too. Look at that. Tearing it up. Right on. You too. Go out there and let's see what you can do.
You want a dangerous skating board?
Hangover madness. It's good exercise.
You go there in case anything goes wrong. You don't die first, like in the movie.
How you doing, man?
You gotta buy one of my t-shirts. Join the fan club today.
What's your fan club?
Fan club. You get the CD, poster, t-shirt.
Perry. Yeah. Say that again.
Once you start, you can't stop.
Once you stop, you die.
Yeah.
Is that true?
Uh-huh. I heard that's a known fact. You stop
really?
Skateboarding, you might die.
Oh, real life.
Gnarly, dude, gnarly. Right on, man. You're a pretty progressive skater. I don't know if that's the right word, but how do you like skating? Skateboarding.
It's fun, man.
You're into it, huh?
Yeah, I guess so. But I mean, I'm into other things too.
What's that?
I don't know. It's like really new shit, you know?
Yeah, right. Well, I like to take it to a new level that people can make money and then do this on the side and then pursue their dreams, get scholarships and stuff.
Yeah, you know, for sure.
Get sponsorship.
Be sick.
How long have you been skateboarding?
About 11 years. 10
really?
Years now.
It shows. Let me talk to your friend here. What's your name?
Utah.
Yeah, and you tear it up. I'm seeing you tearing it up. You love it, don't you?
Yeah.
It's like a vortex, huh? You get into it?
I love skating.
How often do you skate every week?
Three times, four times.
Is it proper for me to say skate, or should I say how often do you skateboard?
Skate,
all right. Skate for your fans. A really awesome dude. He did it. What is that called?
A switch kick.
Wow.
Yeah, it's pretty crazy.
Yeah, that's great. Right on, man, you did it. Woo! That looked great. The first time.
Somehow.
Look at that. There is some good feeling when you do it right, huh?
Yeah.
You get it right. Are you gonna go for it? There you go. Oh, he missed it.
Yes!
Yeah!
You're so good!
Hi, everybody. It's Dennis Woodruff, and we're at Venice Originals Skateboard Shop. And it's a cool place, and I'm tired. I've been working on this film for a couple weeks now, and I really hope you like it. It's going to be the greatest skateboard movie ever made in the history of the world, and we really appreciate everybody that's been in this movie. And this place right here is a really cool shop. Bobby owns it. It's a great place to get your stuff for skateboarding, t-shirts, they have everything, sunglasses, you name it, it's all here. A lot of accessories, and from what I hear around town, this is probably the place to get all your skateboard needs. It's a really positive atmosphere. People are positive. And, hey, you guys, does skateboarding rule, man? Right. Woo! You know! Yeah!
We're on one.
Fuck yeah, man.
Life is a skateboard.
Life is a board. Let's just ride it.
What's your worst experience skateboarding and your best?
Worst experience? Recently at Culver City Skate Park, I went head first into the pool and my shoulder's still a little messed up from that. And that's probably my worst experience. The best is just skating every day. There's no real extremely best skating experience. I just like skating.
How often do you skate every week?
I come here about 3 times a week.
Really?
Yeah.
Can you show me your choice of boards and what you recommend and why?
My choice of boards are the old school reissue boards. Never got into the thin boards, but this is an old school Jeff Grosso board.
Looks like it has some mileage on it.
I've been skating this a while now, but this came out about 6 years ago.
Uh-huh.
And I mean, the original model like this was out in the mid 80s. And this is a reissue of it. Similar to the same shape, a little bit different, but similar graphics.
What does it say, Jeff Grosso?
Jeff Grosso, he's a longtime pro from back in the early 80s, and used to ride for Smith Sticks and rode for Santa Cruz, and now he rides for Black Label Skates, and he's still skating.
Who's your sponsor?
I have no sponsor. I am my own sponsor.
Oh, so you work a normal job?
Yes, I work a normal job.
What's that?
Film and video post-production.
Really?
I work at the graveyard shift.
Great. Well, it looks like you're ready to, what do you call it when you're ready to hit it?
Just ready to skate.
Do you consider yourself being in a vortex of, because that's what the name of the movie is, Vortex.
I'm always in the vortex.
Talk about the vortex.
Vortex is just, when you skate, it's just being, well, sometimes I'm too tired to be in a vortex, I guess, but yeah, when you skate, you kind of get in this mood sometimes where you just want to go for it. I'm sure that's what the vortex is.
It is. It's an awesome state of mind.
Yeah, exactly.
This guy's good, huh? Yeah, baby! And how long have you been skateboarding? Tell me about why you do it.
Like 4 years. I skate because it's fun. It's the only thing I like to do. It's just keeps me going.
Uh-huh.
It's like you love it, but you hate it. You get hurt.
Yeah, I bet you get hurt.
You love it because you like tricks and stuff. You feel like your friends, you're chilling. It's really fun.
Okay, well, what do you say? Let's hit it?
Sure.
Let it rip, man. Cowabunga, dude! Woo! Yeah! The thrill of victory. Are you gonna jam on it this time?
Yeah, I'll be jamming it.
Okay, really jam it. Woo! Yeah! Smoking, baby, smoking! You ever get girls out here, or it's all guys?
No, some girls.
Oh, okay.
It's like a vortex. Once you get into it, you can never really stop. Some of my best memories of skateboarding, bombing hills, going 30, 40 miles an hour. Some of the not so good ones are, you fall, eat shit, fuck yourself up. Skateboarding for transportation. I don't have a car, I don't ride the bus, I'll probably be skateboarding till I die.
I'm a skater, I like to skate a lot, I like to skate skateboards and ball surfs. Well, basically how I got started, it was 3 years ago, when I was in sixth grade. I used to skate with my brother, skate his skateboard, you know, got into it a little bit, and then after a while I started taking it to the next level, like, I don't know, like tricks and like stairs. And after that, I started going to skate parks and places like that. And then after a while, I started becoming better. And like, I just keep skating for fun. You know, like maybe if I could get sponsored one day, that'd be great. But until now, just keeping it up, you know, practicing skating here and there. I like to skate a lot with my friends. I live up in North Hollywood. in Sun Valley. Skate a lot of schools over there. And right now I'm just here visiting friends, skating with them.
Man from Canada, Montreal. Love skateboarding. Gives me a rush. Sponsored by Gravity, Montreal shop. And skateboard's my life. That's what I do.
What about that skateboard? Why do you use that one?
Because that's my board shop skateboard.
They give it to us. Okay, well tell about why this board is good. Why you like
it's,
it?
It's Canadian maple. Probably the best. Back home, that's what everybody used, so that's about it, I guess. Drinking beer, that's all I do. Skateboard. Back home, we got fucking winter. 4 months, and I skate in my garage with my buddies. And that's all we do after drinking beer. Everybody should try skateboarding. It's for everybody. I'm 32. I'm still skating like if I was 16. And I recommend everybody should try it at least once. It's not that hard, it's pretty easy. Just bend your knees, fucking pop, that's it.
Skateboarding rocks, yeah!
Skateboarding rocks, vive le skateboard!
I'm a fan of yours. My name is Dennis, and you really rock, man. What's your name?
Leah.
Well, I really appreciate you letting me film you. How do you like this arrangement of the park, the way it's laid out? Do you like it?
I love it, yeah.
You do?
Yeah.
They designed it well?
Yeah, I really like it.
Uh-huh.
I really like everything in it.
Yeah, well, you're great, man. I applaud you.
Thank you.
And what's your full name?
Leah Jane.
Okay, well, rock on. Everybody out here is so cool. One guy told me he used to weigh 500 pounds before he started skateboarding, and he lost it all within 1 week. Just kidding.
Oh my gosh.
Who's your favorite out here today? Who are you rooting for? I mean, probably all of them.
This guy.
This guy, what's his name?
We don't know.
Yeah, maybe he's tearing it up, huh?
Yeah.
How about a little more cheering? I think that would help him.
Oh.
Right on, man. Woo! Tear it up! Yeah!
Oh.
I've only seen two girls skaters out here today. I have no preference. I just want to see everybody skate, and I think you do too. But it is nice to see ladies getting involved in the sport. And I think these girls next to me are just about ready to buy a skateboard and try it out. I don't think you should start here.
Yeah, people trying to get paid out of this.
Of course.
Like, this is like a natural talent, you know? We don't have a coach. We don't have no one telling us what to do. We run these tricks, our damn selves. And it's amazing, homie.
You guys are amazing.
3 years, bro.
Huh?
3 years.
3 years, when you're like...
Yeah, I've been skating for like 10.
Another year, you'll be like on TV all over the world. Matt, why do you pick this particular location? It's way out in the middle of nowhere. It's up on a mountain. It's in Bronson Canyon.
That's exactly why I like it.
Oh, you don't want to be around a bunch of people. You kind of like the spirituality of the moment.
Well, sometimes I like to be around people, sometimes I don't, you know?
Yeah, I know what you mean. Why do you have that particular skateboard? That one looks like a good one.
Well, this shape is made for going really fast on really large concrete and wood terrain, you know? Today's boards, they're shaped like little popsicle sticks, you know? They're made for doing little technical tricks on the flat ground, you know? They're not made for going fast and turning.
Uh-huh.
You know, it's almost secondary to the fact that they even roll.
Uh-huh.
But this is for high speed style maneuvers, you know?
Is it like custom made? Is it expensive?
No, it's not that expensive.
How much?
More expensive than your normal, your average, commercial skateboard, you know, your consumer grade skateboard costs about $40 for just the piece of wood, the deck. This is about $65. This is handmade by the guy who did the first skate team in existence, really, Skip Ingblom.
Really?
Out of Venice, California.
Uh-huh.
Venice, Santa Monica.
And I noticed you have high top tennis shoes too. Is that a must for support?
The kids today wear low tops. I like high tops. You know, they give you ankle support. And then, you know, if you lose your skateboard and it comes and hits you in the ankle, it doesn't hurt so much.
And how come you don't wear any padding?
Well, I usually do. It's just really hot today. I have some pads over there that I'm not wearing right now. But most of the time, I'm fully decked out in pads.
Wow, you're a really good guy, man. I really like you. I think you're a great influence on other people that will see this movie and think about trying it, you know?
Yeah. Well, you know, it's not about doing tricks, it's about having fun. It's about going fast and having fun, you know?
Yeah, would you go down a mountain that you'd go like 30 miles an hour?
Sure, I've done it many times.
Have you ever hurt yourself?
Not doing that, but, you know, if you hurt yourself doing that, it's serious, you know? You gotta wear full pads and be really careful.
Have you ever hurt yourself really bad from skateboarding?
Not seriously. Scrapes. No broken bones, you know?
Yeah, bruises.
Bruises, scrapes, jammed joints, muscle pulls, that's about it.
Have you ever woke up the next day and you're really in pain, but you said, it was worth it, man, because I had a great day yesterday skateboarding?
Well, that was this morning. I skated for 8 hours yesterday and I woke up this morning sore. Best thing for that is just to start moving your body again, you know?
Yeah. What's some of the skateboard terminology that you use, you know, words that describe what you do, like drop in? I'm just starting to learn about them.
Well, there's all kinds, you know. There's a lot of new ones I don't even know because I'm, you know, getting up there in age. I mean, the average age of a skateboarder nowadays is probably 15, 16 years old, but there's a bunch of us old guys doing it too, you know.
Well, you're not that old. How old are you?
I'm 35.
35. Well, that's still young.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, what does it mean, drop in?
Drop in is when you... get to the edge of an inclined surface like this. And I'm not gonna do it right now because this one is sketchy, but it's when you just push the front of the board down with your front foot and just go like that and roll down. It's not really necessary here. It's, you know,
you get more speed if you roll in. But this is very slippery and it's harder to drop in on a banked surface than it is to drop in on a vertical surface.
I bet if you had a little kid, a little boy or girl, wouldn't you bring them out here and get them a skateboard,
oh,
maybe?
Oh, sure, yeah. As soon as they could walk acceptably, you know?
Yeah, what would you like to tell the world right now about skateboarding? You're in my new movie, VORTEX. Tell the world what you want them to know about your life and why you've chosen to do this.
It's total freedom. You don't need a team, you don't need society, you don't need anyone else to do it. All you need is a skateboard and something to ride it on, you know? Preferably something that's downhill so you can go fast. Skateboarding started in around, I guess, 63. There were other...
1963?
There were other forms of a skateboard before that in the 40s and 50s that was kind of like a scooter, you know, but that didn't really catch on. So, you know, in the early 60s, you know, probably 62, 63 in Venice, surfers, you know, when there wasn't waves around, they wanted something else that they could ride. So they would cut out a piece of solid oak, a little flat board about that big, and they'd nail, they'd cut a set of roller skates in half and nail it to that. And then they started making...
Kind of like surfing on
wheels.
Yeah, it's
like surfing. They would surf. They would use that to ride, you know, with their surfboards to and from the beach, you know. They'd carry
there
the surfboards in their hand and ride that.
Yeah.
And then, you know, a lot of toy companies started making skateboards.
It caught on.
Well, it went in waves, you know. There was a wave of popularity in the mid-60s, and it died off until about, you know, I guess maybe 74, 75, when this guy who made this skateboard, Skip Ingblom, had a shop called Zephyr that made
Started making skateboards, this guy. What's his name?
Skip Ingblom and Jeff Ho.
Really? And where is the emblem for him?
This is it, Santa Monica Airlines. His original shop was in Santa Monica. You know, Santa Monica and Venice are kind of like the same thing.
So this is like one of the original guy who invented the skateboard.
Yeah, he really kind of pushed it into the level of popularity.
And what does it say?
This is a pro model. This is a guy who designed this deck. This guy's named Bennett Harada.
Yeah, is he a good guy?
Yeah, he's a Japanese guy. He's a little Superfly Samurai, they call him.
Really? Yeah. Okay, well listen, it's been nice hanging out with you. You're going to do a few more tricks?
Well, I may not do any tricks, but I'm definitely going to ride it.
Born to be wild. Hi everybody, we're at a really, really cool popular store right now. It's called Brooklyn Projects, and I'm going to be interviewing the manager. He's a really nice guy. And if you want to get involved in skateboarding, you need to get some stuff. And I'll tell you something, they've got all the latest stuff. They've got skateboards, they've got wheels, they got clothes. They even have jewelry. We'll talk about that. And I'm telling you, if you're going to do it right, you know. Go all out. Probably for about $1,000 could look pretty cool with all this cool stuff. Get one of these backpacks, hats, all kinds of hats. Really cool t-shirts. You know, I'm proud to be a skateboarder. All kinds of really cool stuff. Oh, look at that. And, you know, check it out. There's all kinds of stuff. Here, even watches and jewelry. And look at all these skateboards. And the manager's going to walk me through and give you a guided tour of his skateboard shop. They even have certain sunglasses. I mean, you know, I could probably spend all day here. It's really fun to go places and film. They have a nice dressing room here that's clean. And, you know, that's what I like about this sport. It's really positive. Hi, what's your name?
My name is Andrew Park, and I'm the manager for Brooklyn Projects Pasadena. And we pretty much sell all the skateboards, all the high-end stuff, decks, trucks, wheels, you know, clothing, shoes.
Oh, give me a little tour. What are these? You know, what are these all about? I mean, go right up there and show me the popular ones.
All right, we got creatures. We got baker boards. We got girl, real.
Where's
chocolate.
Girl? Where's girl? Oh,
girls
girl.
Are right there.
Yeah.
Chocolates are up there. Anti-hero.
Where's that?
Anti-hero's right here.
Yeah.
We got crooked boards.
How much are those?
All of our decks are 55 with grip.
That's very inexpensive.
Definitely, and our whole complete is actually 135. So any trucks, any decks, any wheels, including the hardware, 135.
Who's this guy on the skateboard right there?
This is P-Rod.
Who?
P-Rod.
Is he pretty famous?
Oh, he's super famous now.
And who's that guy up there on the wall?
Actually, Obey came and did that wall for us. It's a clothing brand.
Is my dog still over there?
Yeah.
Yeah. This is a clothing brand?
Yeah.
Who are they? Oh, Obey?
Yeah.
That is the guy? Isn't that him right there?
No, that's not him.
Oh, okay. Well, I think it'd look even better if your picture and my picture were up there.
Exactly.
What do you think? You know, I think it would even be better, but you know, it looks good the
I
way
mean,
it is.
They came and did it for us.
Yeah, no why problem. Not? And why not? Show me about these shoes, because I kind of think that people are wearing like high tops for support. What should people get? How much do they cost?
Supras. These are super comfortable. You could walk for days with them. They're $135. Super Vaders.
Wow, those are cool. What else?
We got.
Go down the list. What are these? Supra?
Yeah, Supras.
Yeah.
Up to there. We got Circas down here.
Do kids come in and buy a bunch of your stuff?
Always, always. They always come in here.
Okay.
And then we got our whole selection of Nike SBs, the most popular from our store, actually. These ones right here.
And by the way, can people order these on the internet through your store? Or
what they could
have
do
to
is
come
give,
in?
Us, give us a call. And uh-huh. We could actually do a phone order. Our website is not, our online store is not up right now, but in 2 months it will be. So if you really want it.
It'll be like brooklynprojects.com?
Yes, or? It'll be up there, brooklynprojects.com.
Cool. If you want it, of course they do. How do they get it?
Yeah, for now you could call us and we could definitely do a phone order. What size you wear, what kind of shoes you want.
Yeah, okay. Oh yeah, what size? You don't want to get. You probably want to get shoes that fit pretty tight, right, for skateboarding? You don't want them loose, do you?
Nope.
What are the most expensive shoes here you could buy?
If you really want the state of the art,
man, I put these shoes on and I'm going to be the best skateboarder in the world.
It's definitely got to be the Nike SBs Quick Strikes.
These?
No, not those, but their Nike SB has Quick Strikes every month and they're really limited. A lot of shops don't get it.
Do you have any like shoes that you know, like show me your products that you sell? That do you have any with your name on it?
We got.
Because Nike has enough money already.
Yeah, we got these
ones. Oh, those
ones.
Are cool.
Actually, if you.
How much are those?
These ones are 65.
Those are my favorite. Let me see inside.
It's a Circa La Coca Nostra Brooklyn Projects collaboration.
Cool. And how much are those?
65.
Those are really awesome. You know, those have a lot of kind of style. Look at that.
Yeah. Check out the side.
I know that guy, La Coca.
La Coca Nostra, definitely.
I know him.
Mm-hmm.
So he's a musician, but he's making more money off his products now than his music, right?
Well,
he's a rapper, right?
Yep. If you got it.
Why not?
Hang out some shoes.
And what else do you have?
We got VSE headphones. These ones are really limited. It comes with a toy inside there.
How much are those?
Those are $175.
Uh-huh.
Super limited. And we also got
Mickey Mouse.
Our Broken Projects Block 28 collaboration boards. These ones are $65. You can see on top right there, Broken Projects Block 28 collabo.
Yeah. So you got artwork here too.
Yeah, we got our artwork. Japanese artist named Usoguro did this for us. The first one right there is actually art that he did for us. If you can see, it says Broken Projects right there.
Okay, yeah, that looks cool. That's amazing, man. And this is kind of cool art. Like, what would you describe it as? Collectible, put it in your house, whatever.
More like tattoos, you know.
Oh, okay.
Would definitely somebody.
I'm trying to be hip and cool. You already are. I'm learning.
Yeah.
I'm learning about this stuff.
All right, this is our Broken Projects website. We recently found a guy that had a tattoo of one of our collaboration shirts on some forums. And you can see we always update our website with what we have right now. We just got into hundreds.
That's brooklynprojects.com?
Yes, brooklynprojects.com.
And we're doing this in the movie is because I want to show all aspects of skateboarding and how you can get stuff if you need it. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely.
Which you do. What are these skates all about?
These,
you know?
These ones are actually just for cruising, not for hardcore tricks or anything. We have...
what else do you have?
Other trucks.
Oh, oils. They're called trucks, huh? How much are those?
These ones are $45 to $38.
And why should they get those?
I mean, if you get a lower quality truck, they would break on you.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you don't want that. You could have a major accident.
Might as well spend like $5 or $10 more bucks just to get you a really professional one.
By the way, is there any way avoiding, you know, I used to skateboard and I'd hit a rock on the cement, I'd go flying. Is there any way you can get some kind of a skate that will go right over a rock, or is that...
If you don't want to do tricks and you want to avoid cracks and rocks,
yeah,
you probably go with a bigger wheel. A lot of kids, you know, they like to put big wheels just for cruising.
I see.
Smaller wheels, like these ones are right here, is for more the hardcore tricks, you know, skating type.
Yeah, because they keep those parks pretty clean.
Yeah, you know? Definitely.
Okay. And what are those little devil stickers for?
These ones actually come with the wheels if you buy them. They're sticker Spitfires. Spitfires are the best wheels out there, you know.
Spitfires.
Everybody knows them.
Uh-huh. I think I should make Dennis Woodruff wheels. All they really are is bagels that are... That are really stale.
Yeah.
Could you skateboard with a bagel? Four bagels?
No,
I don't think so.
You wouldn't be
it
able
wouldn't
to
work,
skateboard.
Would it?
Yeah, we got different sizes of Spitfire wheels, smaller diameters, softer compound.
And you need
compound.
Your bottle of water when you're skateboarding because you're going to get really thirsty. Huh?
Yep.
See you later, man. You rock. Your name?
I'm Drew, and I like to skate. I got into skating because I was playing a lot of video games, and it's a fun sport. I like doing it. You get hurt a lot, but it's worth it.